the processes, the way we built relationships, the way we delivered our clients' messages is completely different now. Everybody has a publishing platform. There's a lot of authenticity questions about, you know, who's got the real facts and who's delivering the real facts, and the challenges in companies, people that work at the corporate level, people that work at the agency level. How do we do this for our client, and how do we understand how we access these media, we use them effectively, remain transparent, but yet safeguard those things that the business refers to as competitive. So we have a lot of challenges, and that's, I think, one of the things that most of them, how do I stay relevant? How do I stay on top of technology? How do I understand, while I know strategic planning skills, while I know how to do what I do as a professional, how do I apply those? And how do they meld with the changes? And how do I keep ahead of the changes? So more than ever, while we have a lot of opportunities, and I think that definitely public relations people are excited about the opportunities, I think the challenges as well are moving more and more of us to increase our networks, to increase our training, to know that we cannot remain stagnant in this climate at all, that we've got to fight for resources and we've got to fight for position, but we also have to keep ourselves relevant. So I think that, you know, one of the reasons that they come to PRSA and they talk to me, and one of the reasons that I'm here, is that I really see the value that I get every day in doing exactly those things. And then with the business case for PR that we just launched, I think we've given our members, and really anybody that wants to go to our website, the information and the tools to talk about the value that public relations is delivering, and then how you deliver it. So I think that PRSA is staying very relevant and staying on top of what we need to deliver to advance the society and the professional. I didn't join PRSA for a long time, and I had an employer who, when I joined her company, she said to me, "We're going to PRSA." And of course, my response as a new employee was, "Of course I'm going to PRSA." But I really didn't understand what it was, and I really thought that it was more of a fraternal or a sorority club type thing, not really understanding the underpinning and the purpose for the organization. Started going to it, but one of the things that she said is, if I pay for your membership, you have to be active. Because if you don't exercise your membership, you'll get no value. And I think we see that every day from members we talk to. The more they engage, the more value that they find. So I obviously had to do what my boss said to get my membership paid for. And what I started finding out is uncovering, you know, layers and layers of value, again, back to that word, by finding people who began to mentor me, by finding access to education and information that I didn't know, by talking to people in my new industry. And I started to see what actually starts delivering that value to the member when they become engaged with the organization. As I said, all of our members have such a passion and really care so much about the profession that every one of them brings an enrichment to the organization. You know, it's one of those things, there's incredible value as you peel back the layers in here. You can get as much or as little out of it as you want to, but it is so diversified, it delivers on so many levels in so many areas. It's such a large, vibrant organization of passionate people that I can't believe anybody couldn't continue to find ongoing value every day. We heard it in the opening session of the conference today from Arianna Huffington that the numbers are one thing, but the stories and the people that go with the numbers are another thing. And I just met with my 2010 board for our first kind of orientation, and I said to them, let's all remember that. Let's all take that to heart and know that as we reach out this year, that it's not 20,000 members. It's individuals that we will meet and establish relationships and understand their challenges in the profession, what their needs are in the profession, and we need to come back as a board and look at how do we then make this organization grow in the direction that they need.